Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting episode of 13-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 13 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to create a bar graph and a pie chart that updates live with numerical values based on your animations. If you create infographics with charts and graphs, you'll definitely find this episode useful. If you don't tend to create these kinds of infographics, I still highly recommend you stick around to learn some cool tricks that may be useful for your other projects. This episode is sponsored by Envato Elements, so make sure that you check out the link in the description below to find out how to get 70% off your first month. Before we dive into this tutorial, let's check them out. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode, and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. Download thousands of font styles and types and find the perfect one for your project quickly with their easy-to-use filtering system. You get access to music for your sound beds in virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. There are also resume, portfolio, and web templates to help you land that perfect motion graphics job, or to show your clients your work in a modern, professional, and impressive way. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. Please like this video so I can take advantage of that ever-changing, ever-elusive YouTube algorithm. Share this video and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the impressive 70% off deal for Envato Elements, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. You also find a table of contents, so that way you can easily go back and watch sections that you may have found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, let's go ahead and create a new composition. We're just going to call this Charts and Graphs. This is going to be 1920 by 1080, 2997, and for 10 seconds, and click OK. And now I grabbed this background off of Envato Elements. They're sponsoring this episode, so this is just an example of some of the cool things you can get from their website. Go up to Layer, and we're going to add in a new shape layer. Rename this Bar Chart. Okay, and before I start adding in all of my elements, I want to add in some expression control. So first, let's go up to Effect, Expression Control. I'm going to add in a slider control, and let's just call this Stroke Width. Duplicate that and rename this to %1. We just need a few more of these. So Effect, Expression Control, Color Control, and we'll call this Color 1. And then the last one, Effect, Expression Control, Point Control, and we're going to call this Position 1. Okay, and we'll be using these throughout this tutorial. So let's go ahead and open up our shape layer and add in a group. Let's call this line 1. And within line 1, we want to add in another group, and we want to call that background. Control or command R to bring up our rulers, and we just want to make a straight line. So let's click on background and add in a path, and let's just draw a line. You should be able to snap to your guides. If you can't, go up to view and just enable snap to guides, and that will snap right to your guide there. Add in a stroke. We're going to leave this white and open up our stroke settings here. Now let's just take this stroke width. We want to pick whip up to our stroke width slider control. So see, now we can control the width of this with our slider control up here. Actually, I want to make this a little bit higher. Okay, now let's set our opacity down to about 20%, because this is going to be like a background. And maybe increase this a little bit more, something like that. Okay, so let's take our background group here and Control or Command D to duplicate it and rename this to Animated Line. Okay, so now let's open up our animated line and let's open up our stroke settings, and we want to change our opacity up to 100%. Now let's take this color setting here, and we're going to go up to our color 1 expression control, and I'm just going to change it to something maybe like a blue. With animated line highlighted, let's add in a trim pass because this is what's going to be animating this line. And so you want to make sure that you're actually in animated line. The way I dropped it in, I must have had contents highlighted and trim pass dropped in underneath this line group. So that means trim pass will be affected by everything above it. We actually want this inside of our animated line right here. Let's open up trim paths and we want to pick whip our end percentage up to %1. So see, it's set to 0 and we see that the line disappeared. Well, if you start to adjust this, you'll see that it starts to fill in. And we actually want this to begin from the bottom, not from the top. If you click this right here, this reverses your path direction. So this should come from the bottom now once you click that. And so now this works the way we want it to. And just make sure that you stay within 0 to 100% on the slider control. You can actually go above it and beneath it, but you want to stay somewhere between 0 and 100. I'm going to set this maybe something like 25. Okay, and let's Control or Command T to add in some text. And this can be any character. It can be a number or a letter because we're going to add an effect that's going to completely take control of this layer. Let's go up to Effect, and we want to go to Text and choose Numbers. Choose your font from here. So I'm going to choose Gotham Narrow, and I want to use the ultra setting and click OK. And as you can see, everything changes. Something to know about this effect is that it disables all of your transform properties. So position, rotation, none of that's going to work. Everything will be controlled within this effect. So first thing, let's increase this a little bit so we can see it better. Okay, and let's change our fill color to white. And then let's get rid of these decimal places right here where it says decimal places 3. Just make that 0. So let's click on bar chart here and let's just lock down this layer so that way we can see all these expression controls. And then let's open up our text layer here under effects and numbers. So open up fill and stroke and let's pick whip this position here to our position 1 point control. So now this is going to be what's controlling the location of this text. Just put it maybe somewhere down here. Open up this format setting here, and then for our value, we want to pick whip this up to percent. So now our trim paths and the value for this layer are both set to the same percent expression control, so they should match. As we can see, this changed to 25. And so see, as this increases and decreases, our number is going to change with it. Okay, and let's just unlock this, and I want to make a few more adjustments to this effect right here. Unclick proportional spacing, and then let's open this tracking up a little bit. And the reason why I want to do that is because, see now, if we animate this percent here, it just looks a little bit better. Okay, and so now we can animate this. If we come back to the beginning, let's just set this percent to 0, and we want to make a keyframe. So now we can hit U to pull up that keyframe. It may be about a second, and we'll say change this to like 75%, for example. And then, so this is the basic effect that you get, which is exactly what we want. And I'm going to right click this keyframe assistant ease in. So now we can add more of these bars here. So if we open up our shape layer under line 1, we can just duplicate that. So now we have line 2. So now just make sure that you duplicate your expression controls as well. Stroke width, we can leave alone, but let's highlight percent color and position 1, Control or Command D. And now we have percent color and position 2. Open up this line 2 group under animated line. All we have to do is open up our stroke settings and we just change this color to color 2. And let's change this to make it different. And we also want to adjust our trim path. So now this in percentage is going to go to percent 2. And then we can open up our transform properties for this group here. So we'll transform and we can just move the position over so it's maybe right next to it. And then we also need to duplicate our text layer and hit EE to bring up our expressions. Okay, and then click on bar chart and let's lock down this layer so that way we can see the expression controls. And now let's just take this value and we want to pick whip this up to percent 2. Then go to this position expression and pick whip that to position 2. Move this over a little bit, something like that. If we hit U to bring up our keyframes, let's just make this second value something else. So maybe 37. So you can make as many of these as you like. Just make sure that you're duplicating the right expression controls and you're linking everything up the right way. And actually, I'm just going to make one more real quick just so you can see how this is done one more time. So let's take line two, duplicate, pull line three underneath line two. And we want to just take percent two, color two, position two, controller command D. So now we have percent, color, and position three. So open up our line three settings under animated line. Open up our stroke settings, pick whip this color up to color three. And now maybe we want to change this color to something else. We want to take this stroke width and we want to pick whip that to percent three. And then let's move this line group. So line three, transform, move the position over. As we see, something's not quite lining up right here. So let's make sure that everything is connected. Stroke width, maybe I may have picked up the wrong slider control. Yeah, there we go. We want to take our trim paths and we want to pick whip that to percent three. Let's take this text layer, controller command D to duplicate that and hit EE. And we already have this layer locked right here. So let's just take our value and we want to go to percent three and we want our position to go to position three. So now we can move this over. Let's click on our bar chart, hit U, and we want to make this end value, maybe we'll go like 92. And so now, so if we watch that back, we can see the effect that we get. And like I said, you can make as many of these as you'd like. Just make sure that you're duplicating your expression controls and you're linking everything to where it needs to go. So I want to do just one more thing real quick that's kind of cool. It's going to be a pie chart. So we're going to go to Layer, New shape layer, and we're going to call this pie chart. And we just need to add in a few expression controls. So let's go to effect. And this time we need to get an expression control for a color control. And maybe just change this to something like a green. And then we just need another one for point control, and we'll call this position. Open up our shape layer here, and let's add in a group. And we'll call that background. And within background, let's add in an ellipse, and let's add in a stroke. So I'm just going to move this over so it's not on top of our bar graph over here. So the key to making this work is you want to take your stroke width and pick whip it up to your ellipse size. So if these two values are identical, trim paths will animate this on like a pie chart. So this is our background layer. So let's just make this opacity, we'll say 20%. And then let's duplicate the background layer and we'll rename this to animated circle. And this is what's going to be animating here. So let's open up our animated circle and stroke settings. Let's set our opacity back up to 100. Let's pick up the color up to our color control. And then within animated circle, let's add in a trim paths. As we animate this in percentage, it's going to animate on like a pie chart. So we can go at the very beginning, put a keyframe there, go for maybe about a second, and say we'll say 67. So we can see how it's going to animate on. And again, the key to this is under your stroke settings, you want to make sure that your stroke width is pick whipped up to your ellipse path size. So now if we want to add in a number similar to the way we did for our bar graphs, just take one of these and control D to duplicate it, click EE. And then if you click on pie chart, just lock that down. Let's take this position and pick whip up to position control right there. So now we can move this over so it's on top and maybe move this on top of our pie chart. Take our value, we can actually pick whip this to our trim path in percentage. So now that's going to match up with whatever our percentage is. So see, this is just another way to link that value to the trim paths. Okay, so that's how you can create some charts and graphs using some expression controls and shape layers. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. And share my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and tell me what you learned from this episode. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers. And it's guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the awesome 70% off deal for Envato Elements, and the project files are all in the description below. As always, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.